Miccheck Global exclusive. We got A-Gang. What up, man?
What's the word? How y'all doing out there, man?
Chilling, chilling. So, what is your stage name come from? Where is it originally?
The name A-Gang, I actually got when I was in school from a girl named, her nickname was Big Pimpin'. They was giving everybody nicknames, and the nicknames made sense for who they gave them to, and they decided to call me A-Game. And I just happened to run with that as my stage name when I did start to do music, because I didn't really, it wasn't like I've been doing this since I was little and nothing like that, so I always had a name. It's just people happened to have called me A-Game, and it made sense for music, so.
That's what's up. So how long have you been rapping professional?
I say probably since like 2010. Mm-hmm. I say 2008. I started recording. I mean, my first performance was actually when I was like 13, but I didn't take it serious. The idea of being a rapper, you know, this ain't real.
It's right.
Most people not gonna ever be able to find some true success in it. So it's not something that I really thought about. But 2008, I started recording. But 2010 is when I really started making the moves and like, okay, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. So. Mm,
that's dope. So, your St. Louis career, how was that transitioning now to more of a regional career?
When you're from St. Louis, because we don't have a music industry, you have to be the music industry for yourself. So for example, if you a Brooklyn artist, New York artist or a California artist or Chicago, typically the way that their systems are set up, if you're decent, you'll get a booking agent, you'll get a market person, marketer, you'll get PR, you'll get all of those different types of things that most artists need. Whereas being from here, since you have to do it yourself, I'm my own booking agent, you know, all of those different things. It's kind of easy, you know. I'm about to go to California for a month in the wintertime, and I've been there before, but coming back here and being an artist from St. Louis and trying to capitalize on the St. Louis market, it makes you have to do so much stuff that when I go to a place like California, which is a music industry city, I'm so far ahead of the other artists because they're kind of spoiled.
Right.
We got to really, you know, get it out the mud, so to speak.
That's what's up. So, in your opinion, being a St. Louis artist, what is your viewpoint on that itself? Being an STL artist, hip hop artist, growing up into that?
You know, I think that it's a gift and a curse. I think that, you know, our hustle can't be matched. You know, you might see right now, I got a little beard, a little whiskers, man, but this is my work fish, man. You ain't got no cuts when you're really working, you know. It's like, I'm going to go out rough, not really worry about appearance, anything like that. I'm really, 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 really going to grind, but that's the gift. But the curse is we are all, you know, probably because of some of the things that happen prior to us in our industry, but we're very selfish. We really like, I got to be the first one to blow up, and then, you know, everybody else can wait, or maybe they get to eat off of it, versus understanding the value of really working with people. You know, that value isn't instilled in us. So, again, it is, you know, the gift. Again, we're going to hustle harder than everybody else, but the curse is just that, again, we might not hustle as smart as we could because we don't really know better, but it's pros and cons to everything.
Right. So, man, some of the positive things you've been hearing from your fans, you know, of your well-received single that you have out in your mixtapes. Can you talk about the positive stuff of your music?
We've been traveling everywhere, New Orleans lately, Texas, and we have yet to release. Shameless plug. Before the war, this has really just been a moment in time. Mm-hmm. It's just been before I dropped my project Hottest in the City 3. Mm-hmm. We'd have sold about 4,000 copies nationwide without any help from the internet. This is just the people that we meet, you know. Again, I try to perform 3 to 4 times a week. You know, some weeks obviously I don't, but we make sure that we're in front of people and we selling that product. And these people purchasing it really let us know that the value of what we have is a lot higher than the city of St. Louis is currently giving me credit for. Again, everybody doesn't know that. The people have been accepting it. It's great. We really just, we very hard on ourselves. So whatever people have been saying positive, we appreciate it, very humble by it. But we very, very hungry, and we understand that it's what we have done. What we've done so far isn't a lot. And that's really just the mindset that we have. Again, it's just, what can we do next? How can we build? Versus taking it easy, like, oh man, they like this song. Because that's not going to get me very far when, again, you got guys from St. Louis hustling very hard to try and get their music put out as well. And again, you think about all the artists in the nation. So
that's what's up. So why do you think you don't get the credit you deserve? Because I don't know many artists that have sold 100 CDs.
That's true. That's true.
Like, what?
Well, you know, it's when shows come to the city. Again, it's the gift and the curse. Again, St. Louis not having a music industry, people aren't, they're not record executives. They don't understand what's next or what's new. The people who matter anyway, so that's the promoters. Or whether they're jaded by politics, whatever it may be, they're not gonna take into account that I'm putting in all of this work. Again, social media make it very easy to see what everybody's doing.
Right.
So any moves that I make is very easy to see. This is what he's doing. This is what's going on. Yet the people in the powerful positions aren't making the moves accordingly. Mm-hmm. Again, you know, my new favorite word is nepotism. I learned that as just showing favor to people who you may know or have a bond with. So they still will give the shows to people who may not be working as hard. Whereas if we had a music industry or people who truly wanted to see the city of St. Louis succeed in music, you would reward the people truly working. Mm-hmm. And you would reward the high quality music. Again, SoundCloud is very easy and accessible form of media or a music outlet where you see numbers.
Right.
Compared to every artist in St. Louis, I'm very high in that ranking.
Right.
Especially when you consider, again, I'm not throwing any shade at anybody at all, but people do pay for views.
Mm-hmm.
I don't at all.
Mm-hmm.
And the numbers, you know, are still pretty damn good.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, but, you know, the DJs, again, and I'm not blaming anybody, but I know DJs that know who I am and what I do, but my music isn't, it's not being pushed. Again, I'm not blaming them. I just say I gotta work harder. But again, so no, I don't feel like I get the credit I deserve. But Eminem was on what was that record? I Am, whatever you say I am. Was that the second album?
I think so.
And he was saying he don't feel like he gonna never get. No, on the Eminem show, he was saying he don't think he gonna get the proper credit he deserves. So I'll probably always feel like this was my point.
Mm-hmm.
He was four albums deep and was saying, I ain't even dropped the real album yet, and I'm saying stuff like that.
Right, right. That's what's up. So what are the collaborations on tape that you have in?
I got Brian Stewart, I got Penelope Jones, I got Jordan Jones.
She's supposed to be stopping by too, by the way.
Penelope?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, that's my girl, man. We go back. It's a real hot record. It's called G Part 2. The first one was received very well in my first mixtape, so we did a part 2. It's a real dope record. Let me see, I said Brian Stewart, Dave-O, Jordan. Okay, my producer's David Green out of Florida, D-Hood. I got Justin Chiefer. Those are productions. Even a guy named Astro out of Chicago. We working on a few more. I just recently did a few YV. I did their feature. A girl named Lindsay Alderman out of Kansas. She real dope. Check her out. I'm trying to think. I don't know, man. My boy out of New Orleans. What's my homie name? What's dude name? Young, I don't know, man. I'm just not in the mindset for me. Young Dizzy, I think it's Young Dizzy. It is Young Dizzy. Young Dizzy 504. Shout out to him, man. He cold, crazy, but he cold. You're gonna see just a lot of features, man. Especially up until I drop.
That's what's up. When is that? Do we have a release date for that?
Nope. I don't want to drop nothing. You know, have a. I want to make sure that, again, my name is A Game. So when I do drop it, it's going to be something that really move people. Again, I sold a lot of copies of my project. I don't care less about some downloads, realistically. Mm-hmm. But if I drop it, I want it to be big. I don't want to curse myself and tell y'all who DJing it, but it's a DJ from Chicago who did host some pretty big national mixtapes. So as long if that go through, that's another, you know, huge benefit and something that I'm, again, gonna try to make happen for other people too, you know, them be able to utilize him at a good rate. But I don't have a date, man. You get it when you get it. You can see me live though, and you can get a lot of stuff that nobody got. You can see me live on November 8th at the Ready Room. I'll open it up for Ty Dolla $ign and Lil Bibby.
Who else on that bill? Just you open it up?
No. It's a guy named Marco. I don't know him very well. Okay. But it's Ty, Bibby, the guy Marco, and it's a dude named, I think, Joe Moses out of California. It's definitely going to be a great show. Shout out to Mike Judy, real good guy. Again, one of the better promoters in the city. You should definitely work with him if you haven't.
For sure. So, man, 5 to 10 years, man, where you see yourself?
5 to 10 years. You know that mural on the side of the finished vinyl? Man, one of them.
You on the right side?
The mural, man. You know, what we trying to do is a lot bigger than myself, you know, again. It's all about the legacy you leave, man. How people gonna remember you when you're gone. And I want to be responsible for other artists other than myself making it out of St. Louis and finding a certain level of success that not only they can be proud of, but their families can. And they can survive on that success. So what I do, again, you know, with the competitions we throw or the shows that we throw, people may not understand and may think that, oh man, you may be trying to get some money or why are you making us do this? But I'm really teaching people about the hustle that you need to do. And again, you're not gonna like me for it initially, but when you think about it, you're like, dang, you just put me on game. So being known for those things, a game, you know, ideally I'd be Grammy nominated or something like that, you know, just large, you know. Again, the last time somebody from St. Louis cracked that door down, it got nasty. I don't plan on this being anything short of, you know.
That's what's up.
It gotta be big, and I feel like I'm forced to be reckoned with, you know, when it comes to the pen. So
that's what's up.
The industry they will respect me.
For sure. So Frat House, talk some more about how that was formed and what are your goals in production company.
Frat House started when I was in school. Just a couple guys that I knew really believed in what I had going on. It just transformed. I came in business. I wrote a business plan, you know, to be a fully functioning production company and label. We'll throw shows. We'll provide services for artists like CD duplication, booking, marketing plans, social media campaigns, brand builders, and we've just been doing that. We've been accomplishing those goals. Frat House, our success will be directly. It'll be parallel to my success as an artist. You know, as long as I'm getting more and more successful, Frat House will as well. Especially because, again, we want to be Motown to, you know, to St. Louis. We want to be Universal. We want to be Def Jam. That's what we want to be, to where people are packing up their bags from where they live to come to the city of St. Louis. Because they like, I just want to be able to get in the same room as A-Game or Jackson or somebody affiliated with Frat House, because they maybe can take me to the door. And our city needs something like that, you know? We need something, again, and it takes a lot of selflessness. And we possess those qualities. But again, Frat House is gonna be just something huge, again, you know, for, I'm gonna be what Diddy is, Jay-Z is to New York, to St. Louis, but putting that emphasis on it being in St. Louis, not something that I developed in Atlanta. Not something I developed in California, you know, it's something I developed here. Now, again, it's very difficult because our city has a set of rules, you know, it has its people in positions who don't quite want to get those up, or they don't want to make things happen, but
Yeah.
You know, we here to shake it up, man. We're gonna shake up the scene, man.
That's what's up, man. So can you give us a Miccheck Globe exclusive freestyle? Mm. If you can.
Yeah.
Or some bars.
Yeah. I say, can I curse?
Yeah.
Oh. I must say, to these niggas, I'm like a deadbeat daddy. Don't wanna be him. Mm. Tell these punks they can't see him. She a bad bitch and I'm probably in a DM. I get paid per view, you get paid per DM. Beat me, I'm BP, I got petroleum. Helium in their eye, these niggas get gassed up, I swing first. I make hits, they home runs, you can't make a hit. You're like, listen, come my bitch, listen, come till I tell her to quit. I never do. I know that my project is overdue, but giving y'all a half-assed product, I never do. Why they claiming that they the best, they gon' make it about the loot. As soon as I believe them and start thinking it's true, they miscarriage. They never do. Oof. I'm too much for these baby boys. I'm like Melvin. I'm like, come here, little nigga, I could help you. Price is going up because it's about to be the winner, bitch. I'm always in the hood like a Chicago. Winner, winner, winner hit. I be out in Cali smoking fireworks. My own boss now. Ain't no firing me for work, bitch. I hire people to work for the frat now. Well-known fact. Ain't game been the best out. A CEO's mine. I had this whole thing mapped out like an architect. You are artifacts, they pissed now, but I tell them like Macy, yo. Hold, sit down. Man, my shit everywhere like Bob Saget and Dumb and Dumber. I'm warming up in the winter, it's gonna be a cold summer. I'm doing numbers like a math major, cause I charge for everything, I'm way past favors. It's A-game,
motherfucker.
I say for people in powerful positions to put the artists who deserve them shots, cause, you know, I mean, I'm gonna get in front of this crowd and do my thing, but also get in front of them guys and really show them what a St. Louis cat is like, you know what I'm saying? And one of the ones that's working anyways. And they like, now when they go back to their city, they go back and talk to their people, they like, no, you might wanna send somebody out there cause you gonna mess up and miss out on the gold mine. And if people from here were a little bit smarter, you know, they would think with their business mind a little bit more versus the personal side, cause we got talent here. I'm not the only talented individual here, so there are other people, again, when given a fair opportunity and a fair shot, they can make things happen. It's, again, it's other guys other than myself, but I can only work for me for right now. November 14th, we in Rolla with the Capitals. November 22nd, we're doing the South by Southwest competition. If you could definitely put this up for all of the artists, November 22nd, it's for rap, hip-hop artists. We require you just send us your email or send us your information at frathouseproductions314@gmail.com. Mm-hmm. You'll compete amongst, well, there's 10 artists. We're doing all genres, though. We're doing rap, we're doing R&B and pop, we're doing rock, we're doing EDM, we're doing maybe comedy and something else. But we're going to take the artists who win, they're going to be judged on a variety of things. Ticket sales, promotion, merchandise, all these different things. Because I want to make sure that when you go here, because we're going to pay for you to have your room and board going to be taken care of. So you'll get put in a hotel, we're going to take care of the gas, and you get 3 shows down there during South by Southwest. It's going to require you to compete, and you're going to deserve it. If you win, you deserve to go. Mm-hmm. We're going to take care of that for you. But in the process, even the people who don't win will learn so much. It's like, damn, I had to do all of this. And I'll be making sure that they're understanding what they're learning. Like, they may not realize that what they're doing, they're learning something. But when you got somebody in your corner that's like, no, look, these are the things that you see how this worked out for you to where you can become a career artist, not one of those. Most of us ain't gonna make it to VH1. I mean, obviously, I hope I do, everyone does, but we may not become MTV, BET artists. But if we can teach everybody to become career artists and develop a predictable income based on your own art, you'll be so much further along. Just our industry, our scene in general, it'll be a lot less hating because people actually getting paid for what they do versus having to hog positions or titles because they ain't getting no money, so they gotta have a little bit of power, you know.
I like this guy. Y'all need to support this guy right here, man. We got A-game, man. So, sign up your social media. I know you You got Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. But let the people know where they can get that.
Twitter, I am A Game One. Instagram, A Game STL. Hey man, I got this little watch.
Yeah, but look at that.
Hey, this Galaxy gonna have to pay me because I'm gonna be promo in this boat. This buddy, but what was I gonna say? Twitter, I am A Game One. Instagram, A Game STL. SoundCloud, I am A Game One. I'm about to that little freestyle. I'm actually gonna drop that here pretty soon. So y'all check that out, man. Get that.
Ew. So man, shout out miccheckglobal one time, man. This is gonna be the last one of this season. We're gonna go and do some more production work. We got a lot of things in the works for everybody who's been tuning in, and we want to pump out these views on this one. But you're not gonna see miccheckglobal interviews for a while, so we want to end on a very, very, very good note with A Game. Shout out A Game, miccheckglobal one time.
Shout out to miccheckglobal, man. Keep doing what y'all doing. It's the end of the season. Y'all gonna be seeing a lot more of them. Got a lot of good stuff on the way, website, all the things y'all need to see. They'll keep you updated. Again, it's A Game. Quick question, man. Did you wanna ask me about that battle? Or I just feel like you can put it out and they wanna know, you know. Just asking.
You know,
I'll tell y'all.
At the very, very end of the video.
Oh, the very end? Yeah. Just asking.
Yeah, so battle, man. What's your take on it, man? You know, what the people want to know, like, how did you feel about it? Everything like that.
I think that, first off, the dopest part about it is that it's legitimately a part of St. Louis hip hop history. Like, that is a St. Louis.
It is on my motherfucking channel.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah, you got it. But that's straight a part of St. Louis hip hop history.
I can't. 2,200 views.
Yeah, I mean, like, this is the thing. It was radio personalities that I talked to said that the radio stations was talking about this battle.
That's
like, a lot of people were talking about this battle, and you know, at the blank space.
Was that battle that actually inspired me to do miccheckglobal. Nobody was really filming it like that.
It was dope. I think that the way that it went down was whack. But I think again, good press, bad press, it's all press. I think that you know, the D-Max situation was whack. But that was taken care of. You know, I'm out in the scene all the time, so it's not like I'm spooked or anything like that. I think people knew that, and even afterwards, I've been in situations to where people know what my stance is. It's like, I'm not gonna back down. But it was a part of hip hop history. that was St. Louis, you know. I think that like was as St. Louis, like, especially because again, it created a moment though where everybody was talking about the St. Louis scene. Like, that was one time where everybody it was crazy.
Literally, the St. Louis hip hop scene was there that day.
It was a moment that made it to work. Because the thing is that, see, people confuse what a scene is and just a bunch of people over here doing stuff that no one's paying attention to. And what that battle became was a scene. That's the scene. And again, Tef and I, again, we're both two kind of prominent names right now in the St. Louis scene, because people who aren't rappers and who aren't creators are watching what we do. So that's what a scene is. And when our scene becomes that as a whole, it'll be great.
I be telling people that all the time, man. I'm glad we see right here. Your fans are not your family, friends, and associates.
No, it doesn't count.
Those are not fans.
It doesn't count. It doesn't count at all. And again, that takes time for everybody to understand again. But that's when it becomes a true, hate to say it this way, but when it becomes a true hierarchy. Not one where people are creating roles and power and people are assimilating to what they think is real versus what's actually real. Again,
right.
The DJs here and the promoters here, and they haven't stopped me from doing anything. Right. So that just means that they don't have as much power as people give them.
Right.
So that's not really the food chain. You absolutely need all of these guys, but they don't stop anything because there's so many of them out here. You know, again, that's why people can go to other places and blow up. True. So you don't need these people. So everybody has to understand their job in this music industry. You know, what the DJ's job for us as artists is, what our jobs for the DJ is, what our jobs for the promoter is, what the promoter's job is for us. When we really understand what everybody's role is versus everybody got to be the star of St. Louis, you know.
If you're a promoter, you want to throw out a single too.
The promoters are stars. The guys who got clothing lines are stars. The guys who, you know, who got bars are stars. And you know, again, that make it hard for the job where you actually got to be a star, you know.
Right, right.
You have to be a...
Your job is to be the star.
Exactly. Where it's everyone's trying to be that. But again, that requires us to have a true industry again. We had one before, Tina Turner, Red Fox, Chuck Berry. You could see all these different, you know, amazing talents play in one night. Mm-hmm. And we'll get back to it. I believe in our youth a lot. Because again, we got some talented people, but everybody just got to start understanding what they're really good at. Everybody not that good at music, okay? Mm-hmm. You can still be in the music industry. Everybody not that good at filming. Okay, you can still be in the music industry. There's a lot of different things you can do.
Street team don't need a whole lot of work.
It's so much stuff that you can do. I mean, again, because there's a job for everything, but it's gonna take this next generation. I think that again, the guys above us, and it's a lot of guys. So I'm not even like saying any group in particular. I'm just saying in general. Didn't teach us the way that they needed to, and maybe that could have been a fault to people above them. We don't know, but all we know is that the ones above us didn't teach us the right way, you know, to do it. It wasn't nothing created. Again, we looking at a bunch of people, you know. We don't know anybody who has had true musical success in St. Louis who could have mentored us in the last 5-10 years. You know, Nelly's stuff was like 20 years ago. Well, not 20, I mean, his was about a decade ago. Maybe 10-15 years ago.
Right.
But I don't know anybody who, like, from here, who I could get some true guidance from. Because they haven't been. And what can you tell me, really?
I mean, it's some, but they ain't going to give it. I ain't going to say no names, but they not gonna give up their little position.
Yeah, but I mean, even still, it's only a few. It's few and far between. So, like, it's hard for, you may know them, but I may not know them. So, it's very hard for me to access that. For example, we went to New Orleans, and they have like a artist, I don't want to call it a showcase. It's like a questionnaire or something like that, but it's like a conference. But they do it, like, every month, once a month, to where artists can go and learn.
Radio promotes it and stuff, too?
I don't know. Something, but it's popular. It's like a reoccurring thing to where they know it's gonna happen and they get to go learn a little bit. And you be surprised what people don't know. You know, it surprises me when the artist may ask me about where to go get recorded at, or where to go get copies of something made at, or how do I do the smallest things. But you realize that everything that you know isn't just, you don't just know it, you're taught it. And, you know, thankfully, you know, either I learned through experience or learned through somebody, but, you know, I've learned the things that I know, but everybody don't know.
Right.
And again, you know, knowledge is infinite and is very valuable. We don't have a lot of that here, you know, but.
True.
It could change, man, it could change. It's changing. Again, you know, it's a lot of different things happening in St. Louis. And we are on everybody's radar.
Man, it's gonna get rolling, man. Even though this first thing was bad, it kind of got some eyes towards this one.
All eyes on it.
Because it's like, you talk to somebody out of town, like, I'm from St. Louis.
They're like,
I'm
from Korea. They want to know what's going on. Tell me the scoop.
Right,
so,
right.
So imagine if, you know, again, if you got a good product now. Ooh, okay, now I'm here to roll.
The whole world.
They want to know. Even if, again, if it's not in... You know, I'm not, the world's microscope isn't on me, but I just go to California and I perform every other night. And every time I'm like, hey, I'm from St. Louis.
Right,
like,
right.
Not like I live in California, but I'm from St. Louis. No, like, I just came here from St. Louis. They're gonna ask me. Mm-hmm. What's going on? Because when we was in New Orleans, that's exactly what was happening. Mm-hmm. It was like, hey, what's up? We that's crazy. Is it
cats from the blow up? This say little so
bruh.
It's sad something like this had to happen.
We need it.
But
we need it, man. And again, but we need the right people to be in a positions, you know. We need the right people. We can't, our city can't afford to not have the right people in it.
Yeah.
And that's again why I feel very strongly again about people not doing things for people just because they know. Mm-hmm. Do it because it's right. Mm-hmm. Do it because you know, hey man, yeah, my homeboy right here, and he may not be the best in the world, and I might could do it, but I could put this guy on there. He's really good and he's working really, really hard.
Yeah.
And he deserves it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do that. Because, hey, it makes sense for me business-wise, you know, anybody messing with, you know, somebody that's really working and stuff like that. Business-wise, it makes sense because you're going to get more of a return on your investment versus messing with a half product. That don't even make sense business-wise. But then for the sake of the city, when you putting the people who need to be in these positions, because, again, when these artists from out of town come, you know, some of them be out in the bar. They be smoking in the club. They watching. They seeing what's up. Or they people is.
Mm-hmm.
And when they get an opportunity to see some real stuff from here, they gonna take that back. You know?
Especially now, because all the artists are coming here, they gonna wanna talk to artists about what's going on in the city.
Yeah, they wanna know. They wanna know.
Something had to crack.
It's a badge of honor damn near to come to the city of St. Louis right now. People come in here just to be a part of history.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They not coming here necessarily to change anything. They just wanna see it. They wanna say, I went there, you know, take a little selfie. I was in St. Louis. That's what people are doing it for right now, which I understand, but this gives us a lane like never before.
Like never before.
We have a straight lane.
Some cats are taking it and trying to go left with it.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. Again, that's what I said earlier.
I really want, you know, these new brands and new artists to really represent it the best way possible. You know, whatever artist is going to really take off, you know, you, me, few other people, just present it right. You know what I'm saying? Not presenting it like we thirsty, because I've seen a lot of that, you know, just because this stuff is happening. People jump on and they get real thirsty and want to be journalists now. Like, you want to be a journalist now? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, when did that start happening?
It's been interesting. I think that the biggest thing is that, again, I can't never.
You gonna be an activist now?
You know, I can't knock the hustle, because I'm a hustler. I'm not mine. I'm not yours. You know,
right.
I'm from the Show Me State, man. You stay on your side of the street, I'm gonna stay on mine. You know?
Right.
But at the same time, you know, I think that all we can do, man, is individually just, you know, live by what you say you're gonna live by. You know, for example, with the situation. I could have made a bunch of songs, you know. I could have
did songs and everything.
I could have, you know, whatever it may be. I could have made songs utilizing this situation to my advantage. But I wouldn't feel. I personally just some things I don't feel good about. That's one thing that I wouldn't feel good about. Plus, St. Louis is so much bigger than that one situation.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want my career to be based on this kid. The unfortunate circumstance that happened.
Whereas capitalizing on it too much.
Mm-hmm.
It would disrespect it.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, people eating off that stuff.
They eating it, man.
it's beautiful, man, again. You know, because realistically, somebody else from some other city could begin to shine. And to be honest with you, I don't want to see that. So I'd rather see somebody from where I'm from eat. Because again, for example, the Nellyville show finna come out. That's gonna be St. Louis has a unique opportunity, man. It's like guys really.
What's that? To, what's the Nellyville? What's that?
He got a reality show coming out.
Nellyville?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
That's a big opportunity for St. Louis people because.
It's gonna be shot here?
I think it's already shot. Or they're shooting, or they're in the middle of shooting. Uh-huh. But like, people are gonna be showcased. Like, people are gonna have opportunities to be like, you know. And again, it's so much money out here that because somebody else makes it, it's not gonna stop me from making it. And that's what people assume is that because somebody else is getting shine, dang, they're gonna dim my light. No, fool, it's just gonna be two bright lights and they're gonna be
bright. That's how many people in the world? 8 billion? 9 billion? Exactly. You can get 1 million fans here. 1 million fans, everybody. You know?
So they can buy 52 albums in 1 year. At least 10 of them could be from St. Louis, and I would eat, and you would eat the same, and nobody would have to eat anything less. But it'll take time for everybody to develop that type of a mindset, and it'll take time, but that's why we're doing it. You know?
And everybody don't have to eat off the same plate. You don't have to be an artist to eat.
Exactly, you know? There's a table for film. There's a table for directing. There's a table for marketing and PR, and there's a place for everybody, but it's good food on each and every one of them. You know, you just gotta, hey, find your lane and get in your lane and
go with that mug.
You know, go with that mug. You know, we, you know, you can't spell hustle without STL. You know, it's cliche, but it's real. It's real, because you know, people don't have it like we got it here. You know, especially if you young and black. Oof. That's a whole nother monster. We see what's going on right now. Like, think about it. When you say something about being young and black, at least for being from St. Louis, you gotta be like, you know what? You actually might be right. That's probably pretty hard.
It's helping out a lot of people, man. I wouldn't pull the card of like, oh, he's black, he's a man, he's from St. Louis, but I mean, it might make it a little easier to work with people outside the city now.
You know? A lot easier, because they want to. They want to know, and I'm
that's a blessing. That's again, a huge blessing.
You just gotta do it the right way. And the biggest thing is that this thing, this situation ain't gonna help nobody sustain a career, because A, you can only make a few Mike Brown mixtapes before people will be like, I want it. That's just how nature is. But biggest thing is that no matter what, people still want good music. They want a good product. They want to hear something good. So even if you eating off of the situation or you winning, if your product isn't something that's going to sustain or it doesn't last or people don't genuinely like it, it wouldn't matter.
It wouldn't matter anyway.
So, and again, I applaud everybody for being passionate, man. Mm-hmm. I got my views and my ideas on how I think things should go, but who am I? You know, all I can do is live out what I'm saying and make sure that whatever I want to leave with people is what I leave with people, and hopefully it's the best thing possible. And you know, hopefully, you know, everybody else do what they're supposed to do, man. You know, you gotta try to be politically correct, you know.
Mm-hmm. Try to be, at least. Well, yeah, man, anything you want to say to your fans, man? Any shout outs, anything like that?
It is way too many people that I have to shout out. So I'm just like everybody, no one person in particular, because I don't want nobody mad at me. That's what happens in these situations. But everybody is more than appreciated. We've been experiencing a lot of growth lately. And again, I'm very humbled by it. But the beauty of all of this is that when I drop my mixtape, shortly after I'm following up with an album. So it's gonna be a very, very good time when all of my music is coming out. We shoot a video for Sunday on the North there pretty soon. Just, you know, doing all the right things, man. And just, man, just keep paying attention, keep following. Again, I'm just trying to be somebody that, you know, your kids can look up to, you feel me? And want to be like, make sure my family straight in the city of St. Louis is good, man. Just thank y'all.
That's what's up, man. All right, man. Well, next time on the next season, man, I'll definitely be hitting you up, man.
For sure.
We're going to be somewhere else.
Yeah, man.
And bigger and better HD lights, camera action. You're definitely welcome anytime, bro.
Thank you, man.
My dude.
Appreciate it, man.
For life, man. Yeah. And peace.